Planet of the Fakes 4 Women, and Pig Star HH News. Cops release photos that were tagged partners in crime from Breonna Taylor's boyfriend's phone that show them both holding gun believed to be the one he used to fire at police, as messages also suggest he was selling drugs. On Wednesday, Louisville police released 4,470 pages of documents related to Breonna Taylor shooting. Taylor was killed in a March 13 drug raid after police returned fire at her boyfriend Kenneth Walker. New photos show Taylor and Walker posing with gun that looks like the one he used to open fire on cops. Walker said in police interviews he thought the cops were her ex-boyfriend trying to break in. Text messages from Walker's phone suggest he was selling pills and marijuana. Photos show the aftermath in Taylor's apartment after police unleashed a hail of 32 bullets. No cops were directly charged in Taylor's death, leading to outrage and protests over the case. Photos discovered by investigators show Taylor and Walker posing with what appears to be the Glock 9mm Walker used to fire on cops, as well as with a modified pistol-style R15. The Louisville Metro Police Department has released the contents of its internal investigation following the death of Breonna Taylor, including photos of her brandishing guns and text messages that indicate her boyfriend Kenneth Walker sold drugs. On Wednesday, LMPD released 4,470 pages, including investigative reports, interview summaries, and evidence reports, as well as 251 videos and hundreds of photos. Taylor's death in a hail of police bullets early on March 13 sparked protests nationwide, and the document dump follows a controversial grand jury ruling that saw no officers directly charged in her death. Included in the new documents are photos of Taylor and Walker posing with guns, as well as text messages that strongly suggest that Walker was involved in the sale of illegal drugs. Walker was a licensed gun owner able to legally carry in Kentucky. He was not named in the search warrant used to enter Taylor's home, and he was not a target in the drug investigation of Taylor's ex-boyfriend, Jamarcus Glover, that led to the raid on her apartment. In one photo recovered from Walker's phone, Taylor poses with him as he holds a silver and black Glock 9mm that strongly resembles the gun Walker used to fire on police during the raid. He also shows off a pistol-style, Springfield Saint R15. Partners in Crime reads the caption at the bottom of the photo, along with a cartoon of handcuffs. In text messages, Walker said that he purchased the Glock from a white boy and that it wasn't registered to him, but that he had a bill of sale. In one text message to Walker, Taylor sent an image of herself with the R15 pistol. In another, she asks for a picture of the R15 pistol to show to a white boy she works with who might be interested in purchasing it, according to the new documents. In one text message to Walker, Taylor sent an image, left, of herself with the R15 pistol. In another, she asks for a picture, right, of the R15 pistol to show to a white boy. The Glock that Walker used to fire on police is seen in an evidence photo. Walker was a licensed gun owner in Kentucky. The trove of investigative files revealed Walker had been involved in the sale of drugs, according to messages recovered from his phone by police. Walker told investigators that he and Breonna were scared to death when they heard banging on the door on March 13 and he feared it was her drug-dealing ex-boyfriend, Jamarcus Glover. Breonna asked who was at the door by screaming, loud at the top of her lungs, but did not get an answer. Detective Joshua Janes, who saw the warrant at Breonna's address, admitted he did not have evidence that the parcels Glover was receiving at her home were suspicious. The SWAT team involved in the drug investigation that night were not briefed on the raid at Breonna's address. SWAT team member Lieutenant Dale Massey described the execution of the warrant as an egregious act. Detective Janes admitted there were parts of the investigation he would have done a little bit differently. In the course of the investigation, police also recovered evidence that Walker was involved in the sale of drugs. In police interviews, Walker said that he was not involved in serious criminal activity, but did say that he sometimes personally used marijuana. However, a search of his phone found numerous conversations about drug trafficking, investigators said in the newly released documents. In several chats described in the documents, Walker discusses selling pills to Hooters waitresses. In another conversation, he sent an image of a bag of marijuana, advertising it as Cali High Grade Premium Cannabis 1LB, according to the documents. In other messages, Walker offered to sell half ounces for $25, or two zips, slang for ounces, for $260, the documents state. Police say Walker texted about selling pills to Hooters waitresses, and sent an image of a bag of marijuana, advertising it as Cali High Grade Premium Cannabis 1LB. An investigative report describes Walker's communications with Hooters waitresses regarding the purchase of pills. The messages with more than two dozen apparent customers span the fall of 2019 to March of this year, just prior to the raid. In another group chat, Walker discussed robbing someone, the documents state. Walker asked how much bread the target had, and another person replied that it was at least $25,000. When someone in the chat asked if it was an easy target or whether they needed to do homework, Walker replied that he does his homework on every mission, according to the documents. Breonna Taylor's boyfriend told police they were scared to the death when they heard banging on the door because they thought it was her drug-dealing ex. The new documents reveal that police insisted that they knocked and announced themselves, but that Taylor's boyfriend Kenneth Walker said that they only heard the knocking, and did not hear police identify themselves. Walker said the couple was scared to death because they feared it was her drug-dealing ex-boyfriend. He opened fire down a hallway as the door was breached, striking one officer in the leg, and cops returned fire, killing Taylor. The raid unfolded as part of a series of simultaneous raids on multiple locations associated with Taylor's ex-boyfriend Jamarcus Glover, a suspected drug trafficker. Cops believe Taylor's home was the money house where Glover housed the dope, the new documents state, but no significant amounts of drugs or money were found there, and investigators later raised questions about the evidence used to tie Glover to Taylor's home. Breonna Taylor and boyfriend Kenneth Walker were sleeping in their Louisville apartment in the early hours of March 13, when police officers executed a no-knock warrant and opened fire. In the early hours of March 13, Louisville police officers entered apartment 4 of 3003 Springfield Drive, firing 32 times. Breonna Taylor was shot 6 times, but only one was determined to be fatal. Taylor's name came up in the drug case at least in part because she had posted bail a few times from 2017 to January 2020 for Glover and another defendant, Darrell Forrest, in amounts that went as high as $5,000, according to the police files released on Wednesday. Taylor's apartment was considered a soft target by police conducting the raid, and they believed she was home alone. Walker, a licensed gun owner, was not expected to be there, and his relationship with Taylor appears to have been unknown to police. The documents reveal that the cops executing the raid decided to knock and announce themselves, despite having a no-knock warrant, because they considered the location to be low risk. Walker, believing it was an intruder, shot at the officers, striking Sergeant John Mattingly in the leg, prompting them to return fire and kill Taylor in a hail of bullets. He was charged with attempted murder, however, those charges were later dropped. Walker has maintained that the officers did not identify themselves as police when they arrived at the apartment. During his interview with investigators from the Public Integrity Unit, he said the couple were awoken after they heard a loud thud. He did not mention Glover by name but said he thought it may have been a guy Taylor was on and off with. It scared her, Breonna, to death. Me too, like who is that? I was honestly thinking because we've been on and off together for like 7 years, or whatever, there was a guy that she was messing with or whatever throughout that time, Walker told investigators. Hundreds of files related to the Louisville Police Department's investigation into Breonna Taylor's death were released on Wednesday. Walker has maintained that the officers did not identify themselves as police when they arrived at the apartment. And he popped over there once before while I was there like a couple months ago. So that's what I thought was going on. The report notes that Walker's reference to the guy showing up at the apartment months prior corresponds to the same time frame when Glover was spotted at Taylor's home. He also told investigators he was a licensed carrier but had never fired his gun outside of a range. After hearing the loud boom at the door, Walker said he asked who was there and did not get a response. He said Breonna then tried asking by screaming, "Who is it?" loud at the top of her lungs, but they still did not get an answer. Walker then described walking over to the breached door and firing one gunshot. The interview was among hundreds of files related to the Louisville Police Department's investigation into Taylor's death that were finally released. The files were made public.